Hello friends, I am Dr. Kunal Das. I am consultant and head department of gastroenterology, Manipal Hospitals, Dwarka, Delhi. Today we will be speaking on a very important topic, that is constipation or Kabziyat. Constipation is a chronic condition that affects many people around the world, including older people, younger people also. Constipation affects approximately 16%, that is 1 out of 6 of the adults worldwide, according to various estimates. Obesity with body mass index greater than equal to 35 kg per meter square, coming into super obese category of class 2 and 3, increases the risk of developing or worsening of other chronic diseases and mortality. Between 1974 and 2004, research on BMI trends in more than 200 countries around the world revealed a global prevalence of obesity classes 2 and 3, about 2.3% among women and 5% among men. Obesity has been linked to constipation, but it is not recognized as a cause of constipation. However, a recent study found that obese people have several other risk factors for constipation, like physical inactivity, a poor diet that lacks fiber and vegetables in general. Thus, obesity and constipation share risk factors. However, little is known about constipation in people with severe obesity and the factors that contribute to it. It is critical to determine the magnitude of problem and the associated factors before developing strategies, especially since nutritional interventions leading to a healthy diet, improved eating habits, and lifestyle can treat constipation and obesity very well. Silvera et al. Investigated the prevalence of intestinal complications, constipation, and factors contributing to it in adults and in obesity, adults with obesity classes 2 and 3. They examined the baseline data from a randomized clinical trial involving adults aged 18 years to 64 years, with BMI greater than or equal to 35 kg per meter square. The prevalence of constipation among the 150 participants was 24.67%, that is higher than the global prevalence. So in obese, it is almost 1 in 4 patients may have constipation, compared to only 1/6 of the normal population. So it is almost 10 percentage points higher. In multiple regression analysis, constipation was associated with polymer pharmacy, younger age, especially 18 to 29 years, former smoking. There was no statistically significant link between constipation and daily consumption of fiber-rich foods. However, the absence of whole grains was borderline significant. So it is important to know that fiber-rich foods, it is very well prescribed, but absence of whole grains is the most important in consumption of constipation. A worrying intestinal health profile was identified regarding low weekly frequency of bowel movements, hard stools, and the need for excessive effort to evacuate. These characteristics culminate in a variety of physiological damages, such as pelvic floor weakness, excessive perineal descent, and rectal intussusception, among others. These are very important points which are not well appreciated. And when a patient will go to a specialist and special tests are needed, especially like MRI, diffeography, to find out the real reason. Diagnosis and treatment of constipation in obese people is essential because it means having much lower treatment cost by intervening before any seriousness illnesses may occur. So it is very important for health professionals who should evaluate the presence of constipation, especially in severely obese people, as it is very important to screen for them. So overall, regardless of the diagnosis, nutritional guidelines such as drinking more than 2 liters of water, eating high fiber diet which is more than 25 to 30 grams per day are critical for preventing the problem. So these are not only these things should be done in a watchful manner among the super obese. Other measures which would include fiber supplements, medicines like magnesium hydroxide olive oil before beginning the prescription of medications for constipation. There are many stimulant laxatives like ring of magnesia, sodium picosulfate, osmotic laxatives like liquid paraffin, lubricant laxatives which can act rapidly and are well tolerated in doses that produce normal and soft stools. Very important component is regular physical activity can also improve bowel function. In conclusion, we should look actively for the features of constipation patients of obesity, especially classes 2 and 3, and which are well associated with factors like young age, being a former smoker, and polypharmacy, and treat it before it's too late. So it is very important that we look out for constipation and we treat them at the right time.